I want to outline a 5-step process for doing the matching the headings in the reading test, right? Matching the headings is where you get about 6 or 7 paragraphs are there in a single passage, and then you're given about 8 or 9 headings, and you have to match one heading for each paragraph, right? That's the matching the heading. It's one of the most common question types that comes in the reading passages, whether it's for both general or for academic, right? So the first step that you need to do is to look at the instructions. Why is this important? Some of the reading passages, they would have already done an example for you, right? They would have already done an example, and you need to be aware that which paragraph the example has already been done. Sometimes they do it for paragraph A, and sometimes they may do it for paragraph C or D, right? In between, they'll do a paragraph. So what you need to do is read the instructions. Does it say that you have to choose a heading for every paragraph? Or does it say choose from B to F or B to G? Or does it say choose from A to G, but D has already been done for you? If you don't read the instructions, what will happen is you will be doing it for the example that's already been done. You'll be wasting your time. Plus, when you write it in the answer sheet, you will be marking it in the wrong place, right? So be aware of the instructions. That's the first step, right? Read the instructions and see that, do you have to do all the paragraphs or do you have to do only some of the paragraphs? That's the first step in doing the matching the headings. The second step is understanding the headings. In the reading passage, there will always be, let us say, 6 or 7 paragraphs will be there, A to F or A to G. But the number of headings will always be more than the number of paragraphs, right? So if the number of paragraphs are about 6, number of headings could be 9 or could be 10. So you have to be aware that there will be 2 or 3 superfluous headings which do not match any paragraph, right? That's something you need to be aware of. And then when you look at the headings, you need to be aware that there's always a unique heading for every paragraph. No heading will match more than one paragraph. That's another thing, important thing to keep in mind, right? You're going to choose from 1 to 9 or 1 to 10, whenever the answers are there, no heading will match more than one paragraph. That is one part about the heading. The second part about the headings is that read all the headings, right? Suppose 9 headings are there, read all the headings and try to understand the meaning of the headings. Right, don't just go by the keyword. Read the heading and understand what does this heading mean, right? So what should a paragraph have for this heading to match that? So that's the way you have to read every heading and understand the meaning of the headings. Then you go to step 3. Step 3 is choosing the paragraphs. Now what happens? Do you have to go systematically from A to G, or can you do it random way? Both are possible. Right? Let us say there's a time pressure for you. Now you have done first 2 passages, you have done, there were no matching the headings in that. But in the 3rd passage, you are getting matching the headings and you just have about 10 minutes time. Right? So what do? You got about 6 matching the headings to do. Will you go in a systematic order? Will you go from top to bottom? You may be wasting time if you do that. The smarter way is to see which paragraph is the briefest. Now, which is the smallest or the shortest paragraph. Start with that, right? Let us say paragraph D is short, whereas paragraph A, B, C, and E and F are longer paragraphs. Start with the paragraph D. That's the smallest paragraph, right? So read that and then match the headings, right? How do we match the headings? I'll tell you. So once you finish the smaller paragraphs, then you can go in for the bigger paragraphs. The logic here is that every paragraph will have one answer for itself. Right, so there's no need to go in a systematic order if you are under time pressure. If you're not under time pressure, well and good. You can go systematically, you do paragraph A, paragraph B and C and so on like that. Right? Then we come to the 4th step. Read the paragraph. Let's say you're starting with paragraph D. Read paragraph D. Understand what paragraph D means and then look at all the headings and start eliminating the headings. Now A, you're done, read paragraph D. The heading 1 doesn't match, heading 2 doesn't match, heading 3 doesn't match, heading 4, yes, it seems to match. So keep heading 4 just mark the heading 4 on the question paper. But don't stop at that, right? The moment you think that something is matching, don't assume that that's the only answer. Read all the headings and eliminate them. That way you'll be 100% sure that what you have chosen is the correct one, right? So just quickly read the headings, eliminate the headings, and then choose one that you just can't be eliminated, you know? Then that's a confirmation of an answer, right? That's what you come to the fifth step, where you have eliminated all the headings and the one heading that is remaining, you are seeing that the content of the paragraph and that heading is matching. So you get a confirmation. So if you follow these five steps, matching the headings will become one of the easiest things for you to do, right? Often students struggle thinking that, you know, matching the heading is the most difficult, right? If you follow this method of doing it, you'll find that matching the headings is one of the easiest things to do it. Often it is said that, you know, the first two lines or the last two lines of the paragraph do contain the heading information, but don't be fooled by that. It doesn't happen all the time. Sometimes you need to read the entire paragraph, only then you'll be able to understand the which heading will match that. So just don't go by, you know, the shortcut, no, which I'll just read the first line and then match the heading. Sometimes you can run into errors because of that. So read a paragraph, it doesn't take much time. Read a paragraph and quickly look at the headings and match them. Right? That's the way to do matching the headings.